Hey, what's going on, you guys? It's Sam from CameraLegend.com. Did y'all like that little intro? Especially that little coffee bit? Seems like everybody on YouTube loves that cliched coffee bit. And, you know, everybody loves coffee, I guess, anyway. Anyway, I don't know if you guys remember, but in one of my videos, I said I got the tools, but I ain't got the touch. So right now, I'm trying to put some of those tools to use. I mean, yes, I know production values are very important, and I'm working on that. But today we're back to the low budget, and today we have another mystery camera. And this camera is a camera that not many people have seen or heard of. And I'm guessing a lot of people really don't know about it, because I really don't know about it either. But if you think hard, you probably have seen it somewhere. This camera is the Sony DKC-200X. All right, so the DKC-200X is a passport camera. Pretty much it takes passport photos. Now, there's not a whole lot on the web about it, so I'm just gonna tell you what I know about it, which is very limited. Basically, it's a Sony DKC-200X, a 4-megapixel, 3.98 effective megapixel digital camera that takes passport pictures, and it prints out the pictures via a compatible Sony Bluetooth printer. Now, as far as what I read, the camera was released in 2003, and it was not sold to the public, but more to institutions, companies, places like the U.S. Postal Service that use this kind of stuff, camera stores, things like that. But anyway, in today's world, it's pretty much outdated. Now, as I said, there's not an awful lot on the web. I'm just going to show you some stuff that this camera has. Basically, has this huge, goofy-looking flash on it. In fact, when I first saw this camera, I saw it at a U.S. postal store inside of a mall. Somebody was getting a passport taken, and they pulled out this thing, and I was like, what the fuck? Anyway, I did ask the clerk, well, what kind of camera is that? And, you know, she was nice enough to show it to me, just not to let me hold it, but just to show it to me. And, you know those guys, they're very secretive. They didn't say much, so it's not like I was able to get the model number out of her. But thanks to the internet, the power of the internet, and that search engine, I was able to find out by typing in Sony passport camera. I was able to find out that, you know, this was one of a few models, actually. And it was, like I said, it was not widely sold to the public, but it was sold more to companies, institutions, places that, you know, took passport photos. Anyway, just to show you some of the stuff on this camera, on the side here, sorry about the harsh lighting, you have a, looks like what appears to be like a PC socket for flash, a video out, the typical Sony video out, a says a release, I think so, maybe there was a cable where you could do a remote release, I'm not sure. Seems like a USB port right there, and the power adapter. Anyway, I'm not gonna go too in depth with this, but here's the back of the camera. And the cool thing about this camera is that you can kind of like, you can flip it over, you know. So it would be great if you can, you know, use it. But here's the problem with this camera. As far as I can tell, there is no way that you can use this camera with an SD card or anything like that, because, or any other type of cards, because there is no slot for that. Now, this is where you guys come in, because if any of you guys out there know a way that I can use this camera with an SD card or some kind of attachment, please feel free to let me know in the comments. But as far as I could tell, there's no way to do it. Now, I've read some vague postings where people were talking about using it on Windows, but even that was so vague that, you know, I couldn't really get anything out of it. So if there is any other way, because from what I get, from what I know, this camera, you can only have the pictures sent via Bluetooth to a compatible Sony printer and get the prints that way. But if there's any way to send it to a computer, even, I would be happy with that via Bluetooth. I mean, I tried to see if it would recognize the Bluetooth on my phone. It didn't, it wasn't able to do that. So, I mean, you know, I tried actually a couple of phones. So to be honest with you, as it is right now, it's pretty much useless. But anyway, such a big goofy thing like this, at the right price, I thought it would add it to my collection. And I got it for about $35 plus $5 shipping, so total $40. It runs on four AA batteries right here. And I think it would have made a great digital Polaroid type of camera, because, you know, you can do this and it's big and goofy and people would probably laugh when you take a picture. But as I said, as it is right now, it's pretty useless for me. Now, if you're looking for one of these, even though they weren't sold to the public, they are now plentiful on eBay. If you're looking for them, just type in Sony Passport camera, and you'll usually, the prices seem to be trending around $70 all the way to around $300, and at the higher end, usually you get a printer with that. But to be honest with you, I wouldn't waste money on that. I mean, to be honest with you, even $40 is quite a lot for this camera. But if you put it all into perspective, some people spend $40 on a pair of jeans, $100 on a pair of sneakers. So I'm like Billy Joel, man. I get more mileage from a cheap pair of sneakers. Anyway, yeah, for that price, you know, I don't mind adding it to my collection, but I would love to use it. So if any of you guys know a way for me to really use this camera, I would appreciate it. Anyway, that's it for today's mystery camera. I hope you enjoyed it, even though, you know, there's really not much you could do with it, but it's an interesting piece of kit. Anyway, just wanted to add to the variety of stuff that you're going to be seeing. You'll be seeing film, digital, everything in between. But thank you guys so much for standing by, and I will see you guys next time on the CameraLegend.com. I'll be nice today. YouTube channel.